Hey everybody, I'm Tristan Sean Gregson with a familiar face. This is probably an interview that's going to be the hardest for me because it's like pulling teeth at this guy. I'm a Grand Prix Portland, so is Luis Scott Vargas.
Correct.
We're going to touch on some Scars and Mirrodin cards that we might have already talked about in the show, but we're kind of doing a mashup of everyone and what they think about it. And I know everyone out there wants to know, how does Luis's opinions differ from everyone else? So, Venser the Sojourner, initial thoughts go.
I'm not a big fan of it. I think Venser's, unlike most Planeswalkers, Venser's mostly like for his ultimate because it's, you know, his ultimate's really good. But his first two abilities don't really protect him and don't really do all that much. For five mana, I think you can do better. So,
what's the best thing, like standard, what's the best thing you can flicker with this guy?
An Obstinate Bailoff? I mean, Obstinate Bailoff flickering is pretty good.
That's pretty good. I mean, I guess if you already have Baneslayer in play, that'd be a little bit better, but...
Or like a Titan, but again, if you have a Titan in play, you know. So
I was trying to say you do it to himself, and then you ultimate Elspeth or something.
I guess, but if you're ultimating Elspeth...
Yeah, I know.
I'm trying to think outside the box here.
See, everyone always wants cards that make you win more. I just want cards that make you win, and winning more is...
You'll just cast a Titan instead and be over it.
Exactly.
All right, moving on. Elspeth Tyrell, we've talked about this at length.
Right, so it begs the question why you're asking again. Elspeth Tyrell is very good. She does basically everything you want a Planeswalker to do. She's a threat by herself. She protects herself. She, you know, is hard to deal with, so... I would expect Elspeth to be very good. And she's even better in multiples, like you said on the show.
Yeah.
Where you go -2, -2, play a new one, -2, or even +2 and set it up the ultimate. So either way, Elspeth is very
ridiculous,
good.
Ridiculous. The new one, which we didn't talk about on the show, Koth, dropping the hammer, my new boy.
Yeah. Well, you know, he's pretty good. I expect to die to Koth a lot.
So, honesty, I like that a lot. You expect to die to Vengevine a lot? You expect to die to this guy a lot? Yeah. Maybe it's time to change it up, Luis.
I mean, of Koth, I'm not going to play him, but he does give Mono Red a pretty good threat. If they don't have a creature in play, he's like a Hellspender. He play him, he does 4 damage. But instead of...
Lava Hounds.
Red doesn't do 4 to you.
Lava Hounds. John Locks, he hit it right on the hammer, right on the head.
Well, in any case, you play him, does 4 damage, and next turn you can, like, add 10 mana to your mana pool. You can hit him for another 4, you know. And his ultimate is not bad either, so...
Not bad is a good answer. I think this guy, I mean, is he his own deck? Is he just going to be in every deck with mountains?
His own deck. He's just very good in aggressive red decks with lots of mountains, you know, or just aggressive red decks.
So maybe his own deck. I'm not sure.
Well, that deck existed before him. It's not like you're building this deck because of Koth. He's just going into a deck, and now it's good.
So it's definitely going to survive post. We bemoaned so much the loss of Ball Lightning, Siege Gang Commander, Hell's Thunder. It looks like...
Elemental.
It looks like the red deck is still going to be alive. It's just going to look a lot different.
I mean, it still has Lightning Bolt. You know, it's still...
First Lightning.
It still has Searing Blaze. It still has... You know, now it's going to have Koth as, like, one of its more high-end threats. So, like, the guys it's losing kind of suck to lose them, but, like, you still have Goblin Guide, the best card ever, you know. So...
Lastly, we only touched on this on the show. Mox Opal, your extended thoughts on it. Or standard, or vintage, or legacy, or draft.
Yeah, I hope it's good in draft, even though, you know, I hope the format's like that. But for the most part, I think Mox Opal is... They did a pretty good job of making a Mox that isn't broken, because Mox Opal's pretty awesome, but the fact that it's legendary means it's really hard to get... Put too many in your deck and build around it, or at the same time, if you draw too many, they just don't do anything. They need to reprint Thirst for Knowledge. How to support that.
What a surprise. A blue card that draws cards instant speed. We have Jason Ingenuity. I mean, what?
Not the same thing.
I understand that, but whatever. I would be really excited if Mox Opal was good enough in draft where it's like, and Metalcraft, and now all these other things happen. You know, like,
well, I mean, it's going to be fine in draft, just like Chromox was fine in draft. Like,
I guess. I didn't play it that much.
You didn't know how to draft format then.
Oh.
No, really. Affinity was the best deck in Mirrodin.
I understand.
Chromox is actually quite good. Like, even if you didn't imprint anything, it was still really good. So I expect Mox Opal to be hopefully along that vein with Metalcraft. But, you know, again, we'll see on the draft format. I haven't obviously not drafted the set yet.
Not that long from now, actually.
No, very soon.
I mean, here we are in Portland. Is this the last time?
The last M11 GP. Every other GP this year is Scars sealed, as far as I know.
Yeah, that was not a coincidence that I brought that up just now, actually. So I know this is the sad farewell to M11, and you're...
Yeah, M11 was fine, actually. I have to say, it's only fair that I go back and say that I enjoyed the M11 experience much more than I thought I was going to. I was a little pessimistic at first, but M11 ended up being actually a really good draft format. The sealed format still sucks, but sealed mostly sucks. But the draft format was actually quite good.
I think you're just covering yourself for, you know, if things don't work out tomorrow. I think you're just saying...
So far, I day 2'd the only only M11 sealed GP I played at, so...
I expect to see you there at day 2, so we'll go from there.
All right.
Do you want to go ahead? Send him off.
Thanks for watching.
There we go.